Spirit.
This morning we celebrate the feast of St. Leo the Great, a very intelligent man, a doctor of the church. He was all about peace when we restored. Let us seek forgiveness when we have not been people of understanding, peace, and love. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have
mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sin, bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who never allowed the gates of hell to prevail against your church, firmly founded on the apostolic rock, grant her, we pray, that through the intercession of Pope Leo, she may stand firm in your truth and know the protection of lasting peace. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to Titus. Beloved, you must say what is consistent with sound doctrine, namely, that older men should be temperate, dignified, self-controlled, sound in faith, love, and endurance. Similarly, older women should be reverent in their behavior, not slanderers, not addicted to drink, teaching what is good, so that they may train younger women to love their husbands and children, to be self-controlled, chaste, good homemakers, under control of their husbands, so that the word of God may not be discredited. Urge younger men similarly to control themselves, showing yourself as a model of good deeds in every respect, with integrity in your teaching, dignity, and sound speech that cannot be criticized, so that the opponent will be put to shame without anything bad to say about us. For the grace of God has appeared, saving all, and training us to reject godless ways and worldly desires, and to live temporally, justly, and devoutly in this age as we await the blessed hope, the appearance of the glory of the great God and of our Savior, Jesus Christ, who gave himself for us to deliver us from all lawlessness and to cleanse for himself a people as his own, eager to do what is good. The word of the Lord. The salvation of the just comes from the Lord. The salvation of the just comes from the Lord. Trust in the Lord and do good, that you may dwell in the land and be fed in security. That delight in the Lord, and he will grant you your heart's request. The salvation of the just comes from the Lord. The Lord watches over the lives of wholehearted. Their inheritance lasts forever. By the Lord are the steps of a man made firm, and he approves his way. The salvation of the just comes from the Lord. Turn from evil and do good, that you may abide forever. The just shall possess the land and dwell in it forever. The salvation of the just comes from the Lord.
Alleluia.
your Spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you.
As Jesus continued his journey to Jerusalem, Jesus said to the apostles, "Who among you would say to his servants who had just come in from plowing or attending sheep in the field, 'Come here immediately and take your place at table'? Would he not rather say to him, 'Prepare something for me to eat, put on your apron, and wait on me while I eat and drink'? You may eat and drink when I'm finished. Is he grateful to that servant because he did what was commanded? So should it be with you. When you have done all you have been commanded, say, 'We are unprofitable servants. We have done what we were obliged to do.'" The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The man steams up your glasses and then they get monkey, so I can't see. And I don't want to give you the wrong Gospel reading for today. It's a good Gospel reading. There's one thought I'd like you to really think about today, because I think it's important for all of us, and I think it's a lesson we can learn, or it's a lesson that we can grow in. And it's when St. Paul says to Titus to be self-controlled. You know, we often hear, "Well, I'm going to eat them up." And he's going to go after something, whether it's on Facebook, whether it's you're going to tell somebody off, right? And I think there's a value to self-control, because when we have self-control, the Lord can teach us. Because how often do we lack self-control and we went after somebody and we were wrong? And the Lord says, "Hey, see, you're not focused." And when we're not self-controlled, we lose focus. When we lose focus, we can't learn. We can't grow. We can't see. We're off balance. So it's really, really important to be self-controlled. Okay, Lord, now that's not saying you shouldn't deal with your emotions and feelings, but you deal with them in a healthy way. And I have an insight that I'd like to share with you. When that starts to happen, it's kind of like a volcano that's going to explode. And it's kind of like, okay, Lord, help me be peaceful. Help me be calm. Help me to understand what I'm missing. Why does this thing happen that I don't understand? It really infuriates me. You know, it really gets me stewed up. Help me to understand. Help me to have your peace. Because 9 out of 10 times, he's going to teach you. He's going to teach you. So self-control is really, really important, so that we can understand our own feelings, get a grasp on, okay, why do I feel this way? I don't understand what's going on. Talk to the Lord about it, he guides you. And then you go into the situation, you're much more balanced, and you use the proper words to be helpful, not hurtful. So does that make sense? So self-control is really important, so we don't lose perspective of what's going on in our lives. So I really think that's it. And the reason I offer that for the lesson today is Leo the Great. He was early church. He was Pope. And there was an invading force coming to Rome. Now, he could have went to hit. He could have got his army to go attack. What did he do? He had self-control. He breathed in and out. He had focus. And he went to talk to the head of the invading force. And believe it or not, the Holy Spirit was with him. Through the intercession turned around and left. I mean, it's a really cool story. So how often do we think things are going to go one way and they don't, if we call on the Holy Spirit to give us self-control to talk it out? See, that all ties in today. So let's think about self-control. Okay, let's not look at other people, because right away we think of other people that need self-control. Forget it. Worry about yourself for the moment. And where do I lack self-control? And what experiences do I lack self-control? Call on the Holy Spirit after the example of Saint Leo the Great to help us learn to live in the Lord's love. Let us offer our prayers for our world, our nation, and our community of faith, that as God's beloved people, we turn to Him. Let us pray for all people in the world, and all the different needs and all the different perspectives, that we may, as a world, realize that this gift of life is from a Creator called God, and that everything we've been entrusted to is from God. That we may use the things that have been entrusted to us wisely. For this, let us pray to the Lord. Always mindful in our prayers of Pope Francis, that he strived to lead us to be a more Christ-centered world. For this, let us pray to the Lord. Let's be mindful of the pandemic throughout the world. It sounds like we're getting closer to the beginnings of a vaccine. So let us keep in mind the scientists, doctors, first responders to this health crisis of pandemic. And let's remember, especially in Europe in these days, where there's really been a scary upsurge, and one maybe yet to come here. For this, let us pray to the Lord. Let's be mindful of those who struggle physically, emotionally, intellectually, those who struggle physically from different illnesses and diseases. Through the care of doctors, nurses, that they may receive healing, try to touch and through our prayers. For this, let us pray to the Lord.
Amen.
And for the petitions this morning, we hold within the silence of our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Amen.
Gracious and loving God, you have given us another day on this beautiful earth to serve you and to build your kingdom. Help us to always have self-control, that we may reflect your joy, love, and peace to the world and our relationships, as we offer our prayers through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God, of all creation, for through your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given, human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this wine to offer. Fruit of the vine of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Pray, my friends, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Father.
Sacrifice at your hands, for praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of His holy church.
Through the offerings made here, we pray, O Lord, graciously shed light on your church, so that your flock may everywhere prosper, and under your governance, the shepherds may become pleasing to your name. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just. suffer me the rest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, and to be glorified, O God, who love the human race and who always walks with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son, present in our midst when we are gathered by his love. And as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask that you sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread and said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. And once more, giving thanks, he gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and men for forgiveness of sins. And do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread, therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led to his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim his love until he comes again. And we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us. Grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now to the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. By our partaking of this mystery, Almighty Father, give us life through your Spirit. Grant that we may be conformed to the image of your Son, and confirm us in the bond of communion, together with Francis, our Pope, Blaise, our Bishop, and all other bishops, with priests and deacons and your entire people. Grant that the faithful of the church, looking into the signs of the times by the light of faith, may constantly devote themselves to the service of the gospel. Keep us attentive to the needs of all, and sharing their grief and pain, their joy and hope, we may faithfully bring the good news of salvation and go forward with them along the way of your kingdom. Remembering our brothers and sisters, especially Joel Farrell, who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead, whose faith you alone had known, and bid them to rejoice in the light of your face, and the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to the eternal dwelling place, and live with you forever. There in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, her spouse, St. Joseph, with the apostles, martyrs, St. Leo the Great, and all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son. Through him and with him and in him, O God, the mighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, our Father, be always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I give you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity, in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever."
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And now let us share with one another a sign of Christ's peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you're already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. Be pleased, O Lord, we pray, to govern the church you have nourished by this holy meal, so that firmly directed, she may enjoy ever greater freedom and persevere in integrity of religion. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
So as we celebrate this feast of Leo the Great, we learn a lesson about self-control and the graces received from self-control. The peace of the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.